I think we all know at this point, the Raiders' biggest weakness, in my mind, is on offense. This is their offensive line. There's no debate. Everything other than wide, you know, obviously their wide receivers are great. You know, Hunter Renfrow. I like what Zay Jones did. Could they use another receiver? Yes, I think another one, another number one wide receiver would be great. But I don't think that is the Achilles heel of this offense. Listen, I need to be very clear about this. I think everybody and their mama knows that the Raiders offensive line needs improvement. But I'm saying that the Raiders need to build their O-line this offseason. And why do I say that? Why am I emphasizing this so much? Because as a Vikings fan, in my own experience, I have experienced a franchise that is complacent with allowing these guys that are second-year players or third-year players to try to come in and see if they can work it out. And I support that. I absolutely 100% support that. What I don't support is said franchises not adding competition at every single level that's needed. And if they do, they don't play the right players. It's just absolutely one of the most infuriating things for me as a fan. And when I look at the Raiders, there is some players that are serviceable, but there are also some players that just plain, no. Everybody, basically what I'm trying to say is everybody but Colton Miller needs to have competition right behind them. I don't care. This entire offseason, whether it's signing guys, we made a video about the three guards that the Raiders need to sign, but whatever it takes, you need to get the best available offensive line out there. You owe it to everybody. You owe it to Derek Carr. You owe it to Darren Waller. You owe it to Josh Jacobs, all those. And you owe it most of all to your team, because if that offensive line is as leaky as it has been in the past, and last year wasn't awful, but still, Derek Carr had a tough time. And I hear some of the hate on Derek Carr too. I get it. But trust me, as a Vikings fan that has never seen, in my generation, when I really started watching the Vikings have never drafted a franchise quarterback. Y'all should be thankful, because there are those of us that have never experienced that, that have went through many drafts, many misses, a lot of frustration. But the Raiders don't have that. They have a quarterback that I think is at least very respectable. Like, he is a good quarterback. I don't understand the hate on Derek Carr. And maybe I would if I, had watched him lose with the Raiders all those years. But again, we've pointed it out. It's the defense that's been a big problem, and that is kind of a reason. Like, what do you want this man to do? You want him to score 35 points a game? Not even Patrick Mahomes can do that every single time. Like, he can most of the time he can, but a lot of the times it's, you know, or even the best quarterbacks for that matter. Aaron Rodgers, all of them. I mean, Aaron Rodgers just lost to the 49ers in the divisional round. He didn't even put up 20 points. So what do you expect from Derek Carr, especially when he has a defense that lets up over what? Historically over 25, 28 points a game, whatever it is. So let's kind of reel down on the Derek Carr hate. But back to the issue at hand here. This is currently the starting offensive line for the Raiders. And that's without Richie Incognito. Now you'll see asterisks. Voice crack, you love it. Where you see an asterisk or a star, every single one needs to be upgraded in my mind. Colton Miller has been a very good left tackle, but, and don't get me wrong, guys like John Simpson and Andre James have been very serviceable. You saw Alex Leatherwood, I think, put together at right guard, and Brandon Parker was serviceable at right tackle. But I want to be abundantly clear when I say this. Serviceable isn't good enough. No. This Raiders offensive line needs to look at its options. We already outlined the three offensive guards we think they need to go get. I think they need to at least sign one or two starters. I would be more inclined to two, because the Raiders, I feel like, honestly need more help at corner and wide receiver in the earlier rounds. Somebody they know can contribute right away. They need to hit on those two immediately right out the gate. If they rebuild their offensive line right away, again, signing two guys, signing two valuable and very value-based guys. And then if they can somehow draft two guys, I say somehow because it's tough in the draft. Everybody has a tough time finding guys. I mean, the Miami Dolphins were, I think we had them as one of the top-rated drafting teams in the 2021 NFL draft. And, I mean, they came out with three starters. That's so rare. But the Raiders need to make sure that they address this before we get into the draft, because I think they need to address some other positions, and they really need to focus on that. And again, I need to emphasize this again. Don't let good be the enemy of great. Serviceable isn't good enough. The Raiders need to continue to build that offensive line. How do they do that? Like we said before, add competition. Everybody, I don't care. Colton Miller, okay, fine. You know, if you want to leave that position, fine. Other than that, everybody needs to have somebody behind them. Everybody needs to, be feeling the competition every day in practice. I don't care because, again, as a Vikings fan, I've experienced it as to where, you know, you take a guy like Alex Leatherwood. Again, we've even said it looks like he was able to kind of right the storm a little bit in the second half of the season. Doesn't matter to me. I think, you know, if this team wants to win now, if they want to get to where they want to go, you need to put competition behind everyone. And Alex Leatherwood is the latest example. No more, oh, he's a second-year, third-year player. He's figuring it out. Uh-uh. Best player plays. Period. End of discussion. And I think that is how the Las Vegas Raiders are going to build their offensive line. But let us know what you guys think. Make sure you guys like and subscribe down below. Hopefully I don't punch my computer again. Make sure you guys like and subscribe down below. Leave a like and a comment. It helps people find the show. We greatly appreciate all the support that we've gotten and continue to get. You guys are truthfully awesome, and we love every single one of you. Also, make sure to give us a like and sub on all of our social media platforms, or like and follow, rather. You can find all those down in the description below. Give us a listen and sub on iTunes. And if you have anything else you'd like us to cover, send us an email at thesportsbp@yahoo.com or put in the comment section down below, and we would love to cover it. But let us know what you guys think about the Raiders needing to build their offensive line.